I was sent by the federal government to copy Sunday Igboho's vehicle's plate number. Suspected DSS officer confessed. You see, they have not started confessing anyway. You know, they are just like that. They are just of this kind of people. They are not just different. You remember the first attack that Sunday Igboho actually experienced? That was when he tried to pay a visit to the Afeniferi chieftain who invited him. You know, along the road, some DSS officials, you know, barricaded the road and tried to apprehend him, but Sunday Igboho's men, you know, overpowered them and they flee. So before you know it, they started denying and lying that there was never a time they tried to attack Sunday Igboho, that it was a lie and all that. See, I don't know. If you want to lie, you tell a lie that is not visible. But our federal government are very good at telling a visible lie. Okay, look at this very one now that have just been caught. Okay, Sunday Igboho have said it, that one after the other, he will be exposing and he will be revealing all of the secrets of our federal government officials. And I think that is the reason why they are doing all that they could to see that they get him apprehended, so that he will not expose them and the atrocities. Look at this one now that has been caught. Did you know that you'll be caught? You are sent to copy the plate number of Sunday Igboho. I don't know. See, people, you see politicians, they are very good at doing anything. Have you asked how come the death of this late popular politician, Faweyimi, when they see that you are going to be a good material to the government, to the people, they will see how to take you off the line in order to succeed you. Faweyimi is supposed to be the governor. No, Funchal Williams is supposed to be the governor of Lagos State. But somehow, because they saw the good vision of Funchal Williams, they immediately cut it short and take him off the line. So this same thing is what they are trying to do to Sunday Igboho before Sunday Igboho starts revealing and exposing their secrets. So before he starts revealing and exposing their secrets, they have concluded that let us delete this guy off the line, because this guy is becoming a thorn to our flesh. Okay, this suspected DSS personnel has just been is trying to say, member of the pro-Yoruba separatist movement captured a man during their rally at Osun State. It is alleged that the individual was an officer of Department of State Services, DSS, who was on a spy mission. In the video, the suspected officer identified himself as Sheung Olayinka. He stated that he was sent by the federal government to copy activist Sunday Igboho's car plate number. In the footage, you could see the man being interrogated by members of the Pro-Oduduwa Republic member. When he was asked whether he was working with the state government or federal government, the DSS officer revealed that he works with federal, not state. The rally held at Osun was against the order of police, who warned agitators not to participate in any demonstration in the state. The order was defied and hundreds of people showed up. However, the meeting ended abruptly due to heavy downpour and thunderstorms. The call for secession has been gaining momentum in the southeast and southwest region of the country. Sunday Adeyemo, known as Igbo, is the leading figure in the Yoruba secessionist movement. He alleged that Southerners are being marginalized and it would be better for the region to break away from Nigeria and establish a sovereign country. Okay, for doing this now, what then is your gain? Well, I know that you are actually acting based on instruction of your superior. But at least I know that with this, your superior will know that the activist Sunday Igbo is not ordinary. And also you will know that the pursuit for Oduduwa Republic is no longer a kid's thing. Do you understand? It's no longer a kid's thing. It's just like those looking down on the agitation for Biafran freedom. That's how it is. So that is just it, my dear viewers. So you can see the length at which our politicians and even our state government and federal government can go in getting someone down. That's why if you're an agitator, an activist, a politician, you need to be watching your back, because these people they can do and undo. They are ready at any given time to do anything to anyone. So we have to be careful and be watchful of them. You understand? Be watchful of them. They can't be trusted. They can't be trusted. Never. Never they can't be trusted. So please, let me hear from you anyway, from the outside there. I don't know what your comments concerning all that has just been said maybe, but please, if you're new on this channel, deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.